Hey, what's going on, StoleLadX? Hope y'all are having a great day today and a fantastic week. Today, we're going to be talking about top three add-ons for North America. I decided to go by continent this time around, or at least by region, because every month it is insane the amount of add-ons that are being put on the internet and that are actually really, really good. So I'm going to split this one up. It's going to be two separate videos for these top add-ons to catch up for January and February. And we're talking 25 different sceneries and two aircraft, fantastic aircraft, that I found. And so, I'm going to split this up between two videos. I'm going to categorize it based on the creators of these sceneries and the add-ons themselves. That way, you guys can just go straight to the creator and flightsim.to and see all of their sceneries that they have created. And starting out, we have photos by Kev with Kodiak Island seaplane bases up in Alaska. This is a bundle of a bunch of different fantastically made seaplane bases that I think there's like three or four, maybe even five. I didn't count exactly, I just went over. They're over there on Kodiak Island, and really, really well made for, you know, such simple little areas. And beautiful flying, as you can see right here. There was a storm hitting Kodiak Island at the time when I loaded it up, but it made for some great flying. And then also you get to see the Bush League Legends X-Cub. And do make sure you like and subscribe this video. Click that little button down there, hit the bell, and let's get going. Now the Bush League Legends X-Cub with the floats. This is currently in beta testing right now. You can pick it up on their Discord. Just keep in mind it is beta, so it doesn't have the livery colors and all that going for it yet, but it does work. Rudders work, gear works, it all works. And then the animations for the water is not perfect, of course, especially during stormy weather, but hey, nonetheless, it is awesome to be flying on some floats to all these amazing places. Now this little spot, still at Kodiak Island, is the Car Bay Lodge done by SJ Fly 2, and is another really well seaplane base. We're gonna keep on rolling through this pretty quick. Next we have Emerald Scenery Design. They have quite a few more add-ons. A lot of these are still gonna be up towards Alaska. We have Davidson Strip, Montana Creek, Rangeview Airstrip, Katishna Airport, just loads of great places that are well done. And a little bit about the Bush League Legends X-Cub. They have a couple of different variations. You have the Tundra with the giant stole aircraft type tires, big bush tires. Then you have the Tundra Cargo with a nice cargo pod underneath. You have the Alpine, which you'll see later on in this video. And you also have the X-Cub Cargo, which is the standard tires of the regular X-Cub, but with the cargo pod. All of these have a 23-gallon fuel pod to extend the range, as well as the 215 horsepower performance mod added in there. On their side as well, they have loads of liveries. They have a couple of different livery packs. They also have the performance mod just for the X-Cub by itself, if you only wanted that and not the actual Bush-type aircraft. Okay, go ahead, if you haven't already, click like, subscribe, join the club, become Stole Addict. Why not pick up that fancy livery you got for the Stole Addicts on the gravel and the carbon? Also, with down in the list, I will have all the links for everything in here, as always, for you guys, keeping you well informed on the awesome Bush stuff out there. Here you have the Alpine skis I was telling you about. I don't know if it directly affects the way that the aircraft moves on snow-covered runways, but nonetheless, it is pretty cool to see some skis on those wheels. Next up, Misfit 79, bringing us two awesome airports up in Canada. You have Jasper and the CYBA airfield. It is just going by the ACO code, but that's fine because it is up there by Banff and just a fantastic area to fly in. Now we have Wookiee 42, keeping us updated with the United States Fire Services. We have three strips here that I am going to show you guys. The Big Prairie Ranger Station, Meadow Creek, and Spotted Bear, all up in Montana. Now we're looking at the full backcountry experience of the Carbon. It was designed by Got Gravel, and it features a 29-inch Alaskan Bush Wheels 165 horsepower Edge Performance engine to give you that extra bit to ski across some water, 82-inch Whirlwind Stoll propeller, and that third monster flap of 60 degrees that you need for those slow approaches. It features over 20 custom liveries, and still counting, there's still really good quality liveries being made weekly for this plane. Definitely go pick it up. Our livery, the Stolatex livery, is on there along with the Valkyrie. It is all free. Show you guys this bit of where I was trying to go back to the Spotted Bear fire services strip, where I tried to perform a stall to a downward dive and then land, and ended up putting myself into a flat spin. If you do ever find yourself in that situation, let go of the controls, let the plane correct itself, and slowly start to apply power until you get lift up. And last but not least, we have Mate. Funny name, but this guy or gal, either or, ended up creating one of my favorite airports to date. It is in North Carolina and is called Mountain Air Airport. Now, it is situated directly on top of a mountain, up in the Smoky Mountains, actually, a great area. Very cloudy in the mornings, nice fog when you're coming into the land. And you'll see here that it is a pretty interesting place to be. And here's a teaser for the last half of the 25, this part 2 video that'll be up next week. And so do come back and check it out.